Coming up, I'll introduce you to Microsoft 365 Business, enabling enterprise-grade capabilities in a single solution designed for small businesses. With Microsoft 365 Business, we've set out to give you the productivity and collaboration capabilities of Office, built-in data protection, and an easy way to manage your users, devices, and data within a single admin console. To get started, we'll go to the Microsoft Admin Center. Now, if you're familiar with the Office Admin Console, it'll look familiar. However, it does add capabilities for device management, deployment of the Office apps, security policy creation, and a new quick setup wizard to guide you through setup. Let's walk through the process. Now, in our first step, you can add your professional-looking domain. If you're registered on GoDaddy, it'll configure all of your DNS settings into GoDaddy automatically. Now, if you're not using GoDaddy, the wizard will give you the right information to go into your DNS provider, log in, and confirm that you own the domain. Now we just need to assign some users. If you have just a couple of users, you can do it on this page. However, if you have lots of users, you can save time by using the bulk upload capability. Here we'll enter them manually, and you can see that I've already added a few users. When we add our new users, it will automatically assign the Microsoft 365 Business licenses. For any pre-existing users without an assigned license, the system is going to ask me if I'd like to assign them one of our Microsoft 365 licenses, such as the admin account here. Once we've added users, we can generate their sign-in credentials. You have the option for how to distribute their credentials, such as via email, download, or printing it out and handing it to them manually. Now that we've added our users, we can migrate email from other email providers to Microsoft 365. For now, though, we'll skip the email migration. However, we can come back and, using the built-in wizards, complete that email migration later. The last couple of steps will help protect your data and devices. Here we can protect mobile devices at the application and data level without assigning a device-level policy, like requiring a device PIN. In the Protect Work Files on Mobile Device screen, we'll first set the behavior in case devices are lost or stolen. The phone or tablet will automatically delete work-related data after 90 days by default. But you can alter this if you'd like. We can also force users to save their documents to OneDrive for Business, so that in the event that they lose their device, they will still have access to all of their work files in the cloud. The next set of items configure additional management settings at the application level. First, we'll enforce a PIN or fingerprint for your Office apps and set a threshold for failed PIN entry attempts and app timeout. This protects the data associated with the Office apps while letting the user stay in control of their personal files. Preventing jailbroken or rooted phones reduces the risk of data leakage and unsecured code running on your end user's devices. The last setting lets you control whether users can save, copy, or paste data between business and personal apps, again, to prevent unwanted data leakage and ensure that your files stay within those managed apps. This is absolutely one of my favorite settings. So once you're done on that page, the last step is to secure your Windows 10 devices, including enforcing Windows 10 updates to install automatically, keeping Windows Defender antivirus up to date and always on, protecting from web-based threats in the browser, and additional settings to customize the Windows experience, such as preventing people from downloading apps from the Windows Store or even turning off Cortana. Finally, on Windows 10, we can also automatically install the Office desktop apps for your users using Microsoft 365 Business. This means that once the user enrolls their device and logs in, Office will install without the user needing to do anything. And that's it. You're done. You can now start onboarding your team to Microsoft 365 Business. Let me show you the onboarding experience for one of the users that I just set up. We'll start it on my PC. To get onboarded, we need to join this device to Azure Active Directory. This will install Office automatically, secure my device with all of the security policies that the organization has set, and give me that single login experience to access all of my apps and services. To do this, we'll go into Settings and select Account, then Access Work or School. Now, here's an important tip. Don't enter your email address. Instead, I want you to click on that link that says Join this device to Azure Active Directory. Here's where I can put in my credentials. Once complete, I'll switch accounts and log in with my credentials. Now, before I do, I just want to show you that in the Start menu, we'll see that Office apps like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint are not yet installed on this PC. But when I do log into the new account, Office is going to begin installing automatically. I can see that this is happening if I go into the Task Manager and look for the Office Click to Run process. The apps will show up in a second in the Start menu. Now, while the system does that, I want to show you the single sign-on that I get while going to office.com. I can easily get signed in without the system asking me for my username or password. Now that a moment has passed, we can go back to the Start menu and see that all of our Office apps are installed. So that was a quick tour for setting up Microsoft 365 Business as an admin as well as an end user. You can learn more and try Microsoft 365 Business at the link below. Thanks for watching.